Trinidad and Tobago is not a member of the Inter-American Commission for Human Rights, that is the IACHR, and so is bound to comply with the supreme law of Trinidad and Tobago. Attorney General Faris Al-Rawi made this statement while responding to a question in the Parliament on Friday regarding protection orders issued by the IACHR for six Venezuelan children who were part of a group of 26 migrants who returned to TNT last month. The Attorney General reminded there is a separation of powers when it comes to judicial matters.
The executive is not permitted to interfere with the affairs of the judiciary in Trinidad and Tobago. That decision has resulted in six minors being granted the permission to stay in Trinidad and Tobago. These are facts which are well known to the Honourable Member, including the fact that there is no binding authority on the decision that the Member has referred us to. We must be careful as a jurisdiction to understand our own constitution.
The International Human Rights Body has written to the government asking to adopt the necessary measures to guarantee the rights to life of the six migrant children by refraining from deporting or expelling them to Venezuela. AG Al-Rawi was also asked about any plans to update this country's refugee policy.
We cannot, as a democratic country, ignore our own constitution and our own laws of Trinidad and Tobago. To take the Honourable Member's submission is to throw out the constitution of Trinidad and Tobago and to invite chaos on the mere say-so of an Honourable Member who seems intent on pleasing everyone except the people of Trinidad and Tobago.
The Attorney General maintained that Trinidad and Tobago's international image remains intact despite the publicity surrounding the migrant children.